Hi everyone, I'm Peter Evans. I'm Director of Horticulture here at California Botanic Garden. And with me is James Reed. He's our Plant Records Manager. I wanted to start out by saying that a botanic garden is a museum. And as such, we're an institution that collects objects for the purpose of aesthetic display, research, and education. And obviously what we collect are plants. All of the plants that are planted in the garden are called the living collection because, well, they're alive, as opposed to some of the other collections we have here at the garden. An important feature of every quality collection and what makes us different from, say, a park, is that our plants have known provenance, which means that we know their origin. And so at this point, I'm going to turn everything over to James. And we're going to talk about how he records all the information about plants in the garden.
Thank you, Peter. Let's take a look inside and I'll show you how we document and map all of our collections.
Yeah, there you go.
So here we have our map of the garden. It's about 86 acres in Claremont, California. The map is divided into a system of grids that are 100 by 100 feet. Here we have our varying trails and plant communities. And if we were to blow one of these grids up, we would find our plants in the collection. Each plant has an accession number, which is a unique snapshot of a collection event, and a qualifier indicating that individual plant in the garden. So each plant in the garden has a tag and an accession number, which will show us things like who collected it, where it was collected, and the date, and you know, varying things like the taxa in the area. And if you were to punch this information into the database, you would be able to pull up the location of the plant in the garden and all of the collection information for it. So now that we've seen the map, let's take a look at the living collection in the garden.
It's a cold morning in the garden today. So here we are at our grove of blue palms, Brahia armata, and they grow in the arroyos and the canyons of northwestern Baja California. And the seed for these trees was collected in 1991 near the town of El Rosario at a place called El Coyotito. And they were planted out in the year 2000, so they're over 20 years old. And they were planted in honor of Jaime Romero, who was a horticulturist who worked here for over 35 years. He was actually one of the collectors, along with Walter Wissura, who is a former curator of ours. And this little bit of information that I've just told you is a demonstration of provenance. We know who collected the seed for these trees and where specifically they were collected.
So you want to go over there?
Yeah.
So here we have our Quercus dumosa collection, which is essentially a scrub oak. It grows in Southern California. It's threatened because of habitat loss, because it grows in the places where everybody likes to live. So oaks are better suited for conservation and living collections because their acorns cannot be seed banked by traditional methods. So this specific collection was planted in 2016, so they're getting to be about 5 years old, and some of them are even producing acorns now, which is a good thing because we can use those acorns for any sort of restoration project or provide genetic diversity for scientific research. So having these acorns in a living collection, this is a good thing for the conservation of this oak species.
Okay, everyone, now we're at one of our groves of Quercus engelmannii, the Engel minoak. And so let's go for a little walk through the trees. So this oak is extremely endangered in Los Angeles County. Fortunately, there are other better populations that are down in San Diego and Riverside counties.
But the acorns for these trees were collected in the early 90s from legacy trees that exist on residential properties in South Pasadena, San Marino, Arcadia, and Altadena. And they were collected in over the course of a few years in the early 90s. So these trees are now over 20 years old. And this tree is another example of habitat loss, because where these trees used to grow in LA County were in the foothills of the San Gabriel Mountains. And all that land has been developed for housing and commercial purposes.
Here we have our Joshua tree collection. These Joshua trees were collected in Joshua Tree National Monument in the late 50s and propagated by seed shortly after that, where we have them today. They're about 60 years old, and they're some of the best specimens that we have here in the garden.
Okay, so these are some of the most magnificent manzanitas that we have in the garden. This is Arctostaphylos glauca, and it grows up in the San Gabriel Mountains, and these are probably about 60 years old. They're actually starting to decline, and we will be repropagating them so we don't lose that accession from the garden. What's it doing blooming this time of year?
Wow.
It's one of my favorite plants, Cerseum. This is our California native Cerseum. I love them. It's a beautiful looking plant. Just be careful when you touch it. All right, everyone. Thanks for joining us on our journey through the living collection. And be sure to come by and see the whole garden. We're open Tuesdays through Sundays starting at 8 a.m., so come on over.